Good morning. Welcome back to another family video for Church at Home. I hope you're well. I hope you're enjoying the summer holidays and that you are having lots of fun together. This morning we are going to jump back into the book of John and see what it might be saying to us, and we're also going to sing some songs and play some games, so hopefully it'll be a lot of fun. Shall we start by me saying a prayer? God, thank you so much that you are with us, each and every one of us, in our different houses right now. And I pray that this time would be a really special time where we can think about you, where you'd remind us more about you, and you'd help us to become more like you. Amen. Amen. Well, let's start this morning with a worship song. We're going to start by singing a song that we all know, My Lighthouse. And so you can do the actions, you can join in, you can sing, sit, do whatever, but let's sing it together.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
Unfortunately, I'm on my own. Callum is at work, so there's no one around to play with me. So I thought I'd bring my friend. Shall we have a go and see whether it works? Alexa, will you play 20 questions with me?
Let's play 20 questions. Is it an animal, vegetable, or mineral?
It's an animal.
Does it weigh more than a duck?
Yes.
Is it awake at night?
No.
Can it be stolen?
No.
This is fun. Can it float?
No.
Does it stand on two legs?
No.
Does it live in groups?
Yes.
Does it jump?
No.
Does it come from an animal?
Yes.
Can you sit on it?
No.
Is it bigger than a sofa?
No.
Does it like to run?
Yes.
Is it smart?
No.
Does it live in African grasslands?
Yes.
Are there many different sorts of it?
No.
Does it have a horn?
No.
Clever. Does it have whiskers?
Yes.
Is it cool?
Is it cool? Yes.
Sorry, I couldn't understand that. Try saying probably.
Probably.
Is it smooth?
No.
I guess that it is a hyrax.
No, it's a lion.
Sorry, I couldn't understand that. Try saying start over.
Oh, Alexa, stop.
Thanks for playing. Goodbye.
Bye. Well, Alexa wasn't because very good. Alexa wasn't, oh, I need to stop talking, don't I? Well, she, the person who
Sorry,
I shouldn't...
I don't know that.
Okay, well, we can't use her name, otherwise she's going to start talking to us again. But she wasn't very good at my game, so I wonder if you guys are any better. So we're going to play a game of 20 questions. So one of you needs to think of an object. It could be an animal or a vegetable or anything. It could be absolutely anything. You can think about it, and then everyone else around you has to ask you questions, and the answers have to be yes or no, and they've got to try and guess what it is. So my animal was a lion, and so when when she asked me questions, I had to answer. So, is it bigger than a duck? Well, yes, a lion is bigger than a duck. So we have to ask questions. You've only got 20 questions, and then you have to make a guess and see who does the best. So why don't you pause, have a go, play a game, and when you're ready, come back and hit play. Today we're going to be looking at John chapter 3 verses 1 to 21, and it's titled Jesus and Nicodemus. Now, either you can pause the video and go find it in a Bible and look at it together, or you can let the video play and we're going to watch a video that talks about the story. So either go read it in the Bible and then watch the video, or just watch the video together now about Nicodemus meeting Jesus.
During Jesus' ministry, he taught in public places, performed many miracles, and proclaimed God's truth with great power and conviction. Many came to listen to his teachings, and many people loved him, but others hated him. Some understood his power and wisdom, but were troubled because it clashed with their traditions. This was true for a man named Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a ruler of the Jewish people, and he was a Pharisee. The Pharisees were a part of the religious leadership of the day. Many of them thought God would only accept them if they did all the right things. But no one can obey perfectly. That's why we need Jesus. Nicodemus wanted to speak to Jesus, but because he was a Pharisee and most Pharisees didn't agree with Jesus' teaching, he had to be careful not to be seen with Jesus in broad daylight. So late one night, guided by the light of the stars and moon, Nicodemus found his way through the dark streets of the city to the place where Jesus was staying. He had a lot of questions about the law, about Jesus' teaching, and about Jesus himself. Jesus was ready to explain to Nicodemus everything he needed to know. And that night, Nicodemus would leave a changed man. Jesus explained to Nicodemus that he could not be part of God's kingdom unless he was born again. This really confused Nicodemus. It's impossible for a grown man to become a baby and be born again, he said. But Jesus wasn't talking about becoming an actual baby. He was talking about a life change so dramatic, so radical, so new, that it would be like being born again. Unless one is born of water and the Spirit, Jesus explained, he could not enter the kingdom of heaven. Nicodemus tried hard to wrap his mind around what Jesus was saying to him. Jesus knew that Nicodemus was having a hard time believing him, so he said, if you're having a hard time believing earthly things, it will be very hard for you to believe heavenly things. But you must believe that I am the Messiah. I have come to give people eternal life. Now Nicodemus was beginning to understand. Jesus was the Messiah, the one he had been waiting for, and Jesus' mission was to give new life. Jesus went on to say, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus also told Nicodemus that he didn't come to condemn the world, but the world would be saved through him. That day, Nicodemus learned about God's love and about eternal life. He believed and found his place in the kingdom of God. The end.
So Nicodemus was a teacher. He was a teacher of the law and of religion, and he was somebody who was very interested in Jesus. And Nicodemus went and spoke to Jesus late at night because he didn't want to be seen, and he asked him lots of questions. And this story reminds me that as disciples, as Christians, you and me, it's okay to ask questions. Sometimes I think we worry about asking questions because we don't want to look like we don't know the answer or like we're not good enough. But actually, God loves it when we ask questions, and it's okay to ask questions. Sometimes we don't know the answer. Sometimes we can work out the answer. Sometimes other people might help us work out the answer. Sometimes we might just never know the answer. But having questions is a really good thing. So, I want you to pause the video and have a chat as a family and come up with some questions that you might have about God or Jesus, the Bible or Christianity, any questions that you have, and gather them together. So you could share them just by chatting. I know before we've done the thing where you throw a ball between you and you catch it and you have to say a question at that point. Or you could get a big piece of paper and you could write them all down. I want you to have a think about some questions that you might have and gather them together. And when you've done that, hit play. Well, we all have questions. I wonder what questions you guys came up with. They're all probably all different, and there are different things that we want to ask and understand. And I have, someone taught me once a way of thinking about these questions, which might be helpful. So I thought I'd share it with you this morning and then maybe you could have a go at it. So when we have a question about God, or Christianity or the Bible, we could follow a little process and we can ask ourselves some questions. So the first thing we can do is ask ourselves, what do I think? So when you've got a question, you can think about it and think, okay, well, how do I think I might answer that question? What do you think might be the answer? If you ask your mum or dad a question, they might say to you, what do you think? They can ask you what you think, and it starts to think about how we might go about answering that question. So the first thing we say is, what do I think? The second question that we can ask is, well, what do we know? And this is where we use the Bible, we use what we've learned about God through the Bible or through our experiences. We might chat to people who are wise or people who've been Christians for longer than us or people who study the Bible for a job maybe. We can ask around and we can think, well, what do we know in answer to this question? What can we find out? Then it might be that you need to do some research here and ask some people or do some Googling online, and we can find out, what do we know about this question? Then the third question we can ask ourselves. So we've asked ourselves what we think, then we think about what we know based on what we know about God and the Bible and what wise people say. Then we think about what do we not know? Because there's always going to be some things that we just don't know the answer to. It might be that it doesn't mention it particularly in the Bible, or it might be that different people have different opinions and maybe disagree about something. So it's okay to not always know the answer, but so it's interesting to think about, is there anything that we don't know in relation to this question that might help us? Just recognize it. And then the fourth thing we can do is we can share how we've handled it. So this isn't so much for us when we're asking ourselves questions, but if we were to ask our mum and dad a question or a friend a question, they can then share with us how they've handled it. So if you had a question about how come coronavirus exists when God loves the world, then you could ask your mum or your dad, what do they think? How have they dealt with that? How do they make sense of the fact that God loves people, but then there's also coronavirus? Then we can hear what other people what other people think. And that is a way of getting a window into lots of different people's opinions and how they have figured out difficult questions with God. And so after those four steps, we might not know the answer, but we've thought about it a bit more. We've investigated it, we've asked people, we've talked about what we know and what we don't know, and then we can chat as a group and we can find out how different people have dealt with that question. So asking questions is a really good thing, and we can chat as a family about these questions, you can chat to people from church, you can think about them yourselves, but it's a really good thing to ask questions about God. Now, I wonder if you want to have a go at doing those four steps with one of your questions. You might like to pause the video, choose a question, and work through those four stages to see if you can answer it or get some thoughts around it. So when you've done that, press play. Okay. So this morning we've been thinking about Nicodemus and Jesus, and how Nicodemus asked Jesus questions and Jesus didn't turn him away. He didn't say, oh no, you can't ask me questions, did he? He answered the questions. And sometimes Jesus' answers are a bit confusing and they made Nicodemus ask even more questions, and sometimes it's a bit like that with God too. But God loves it when we ask him questions. And so we can ask and we can think about these questions ourselves, but we can also chat to God about our questions directly. So what we're going to do now is we're going to sing a worship song. And it's one that we did in our last family video, all about how God is bigger and greater and stronger than anything in this world. Because ultimately, he's bigger than the questions that we might have. Now during this time, you might want to sing and join in, or you might want to chat to God about some of these questions. You could ask him what he thinks about something and see if he chats to you. He might drop a picture into your head or remind you of something in the Bible, or remind you of a word or a phrase. There's lots of ways that he might be able to speak to us, but it's a time, if you want to, you could use to chat to God about something. So let's use this space to worship God, to chat to him, to ask him questions, and then we'll come back together afterwards.
into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are high.
For joining me this morning. I hope it was fun. I hope your game of 20 questions went well, and that maybe you've maybe learned something new about thinking about questions that we might have about God. And I just want to encourage you to keep chatting to God, to keep asking questions, and to keep thinking about all those big things, because they're really good things to think about. I hope you have a really lovely week, and I will see you again next week.